Are you sure you should continue? As you wish.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, it's good to see you. Investigation? But you knew deviants could be unstable. You should have been more cautious.
I thought I could make it talk. It was a judgment error.
Never mind. I'm sure you'll be more careful in the future. The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
It simulated human emotion, fear in particular, in a very convincing way. It seemed completely overwhelmed by them and behaved irrationally.
This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the deviancy case. What do you make of him?
He's obviously not what I was expecting, but I don't have enough information yet to form a definitive opinion.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will try to establish a friendly relationship. If I can get him to trust me, it will be helpful for the investigation.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous. You're the most advanced prototype Cyberlife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
Tensions in the Arctic have reached a new level, with a Russian carrier and an American patrol boat. Several warning shots were exchanged, apparently with no damage or casualties to
report. Says they come.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Anderson's desk.
Defense, Dennis Riggs.
It's that desk right there.
Intolerable
provocation that cannot go unanswered. The countries in the region, particularly Sweden.
The forensics.
So far, there has been no response from either Moscow or Washington. We'll keep you informed minute by minute as the situation develops.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before.
Call Hank Anderson.
Hi, this is Hank. Not here at the moment. You can leave a message if that's what turns you on, but don't expect me to call back. Beep. Whatever.
It's good to see you again, Lieutenant.
Oh, Jesus. Hank! In my office!
Cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents. Old ladies, android maids, and that kind of crap. But now, we're getting reports of assaults, and even homicide, like that guy last night. This isn't just CyberLife's problem anymore. It's now a criminal investigation, and we've got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I got to be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Bullshit! The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you let me hold the bag.
CyberLife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner. No fucking way. I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick.
Hank, you are seriously starting to piss me off. You are a police lieutenant. You are supposed to do what I say and shut your goddamn mouth.
You know what my goddamn mouth has to say to you?
Okay. Huh? Okay. I'll pretend like I didn't hear that. So I don't have to add any more pages to your disciplinary folder, because it already looks like a fucking novel. This conversation is over.
Jeffrey, Jesus Christ, why are you doing this to me? You know how much I hate these fucking things. Why are you doing this to me?
Listen, I've had just about enough of your bitching. Either you do your job or you hand in your badge. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do.
It's an honor to be working with you, Lieutenant. I'm sure we'll make a great team.
Maybe they're trying out a new format.
In any case,
you really need the
forensics. I'd like you to know I'm very happy to be working with you. I'm sure we'll make a great team. Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
You have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
The dog hairs on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
What's it to you? Sumo. I call him Sumo.
You're a Detroit Gears fan, right? Denton Carter scored 53% of his shots from the three-point line yesterday. Did you see the game?
That's what I was watching at the bar last night.
Oh. Do you listen to Knights of the Black Death? I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, I don't really listen to music as such, but I'd like to. A lot of people don't appreciate having androids around. I was wondering, is there any reason in particular you despise me?
Yeah, there is one.
Take a look at these samples yet?
Lab report says they cut it with something.
Have you known Captain Fowler for long?
Yes. Too long.
You really need the forensics.
If you have any files on deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
Terminal's on your desk. Knock yourself out.
Files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have murdered a man last night. That could be a good starting point for our investigation. I understand you're facing personal issues, Lieutenant. But you need to move past them, and...
Hey! Don't talk to me like you know me. I'm not your friend, and I don't need your advice, okay?
I've been assigned this mission, Lieutenant. I didn't come here to wait until you feel like working.
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off. But things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant? I'm sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that killed the guy last night. It's been sighted in the Ravendale district.
I'm on it.
Alice. Wake up, Alice. So it wasn't a nightmare.
No. No, it wasn't a nightmare. How do you feel?
I'm cold. What are we gonna do now?
That android we saw yesterday, he gave me an address. He said we could get help there. The train passes just on the other side of the road. The station can't be far. You feel okay to walk a little? Let's go then.
You're pretty like that. You really look like a human now.
The police are on our trail.
That's all for now. Ready to go.
We've got officers sweeping the neighborhood in case anybody saw anything.
Okay, well, let me know if they turn anything up.
What are you gonna do with that?
I have no idea.
It took the first bus that came along. Stayed at the end of the line. Its decision wasn't planned. It was driven by fear.
Androids don't feel fear.
Deviants do. They get overwhelmed by their emotions and make irrational decisions.
All right, well, that still doesn't tell us where it went.
It didn't have a plan, and it had nowhere to go. Maybe it didn't go far.
Maybe. Get far.
We'll find it sooner or later. Let's go.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a pro-
Sorry. Excuse me.
So
Welcome to Jericho.
Plastic with you?
Me too.
Hey, Hank. How you doing, man?
Hey, sick.
But listen, I got a shit-hot tip for you. Number 5 in the third. Lickety split. That Philly's one hell of a chaser. You want a flutter?
Last shit-hot tip you gave me sent me back a week's wages, baby.
Come on, this is different. It's 100% guaranteed. You can't go wrong.
Man.
Damn straight. Hey, you won't regret this.
What is your problem? Don't you ever do as you're told? Look, you don't have to follow me around like a poodle.
Now that we're partners, I thought it would be a good idea to get to know each other better so we can work as a team.
We are not partners. I am a human. You are a machine. So just spare me that buddy of bullshit program, okay? Here you go. Ah, thanks, Gary. I'm starving.
Don't leave that thing here.
Not a chance. Follows me everywhere. See?
This Pedro, he was proposing illegal gambling. Am I right?
Yeah.
And you made a bet?
Yeah.
I don't want to alarm you, Lieutenant, but I think your friends are engaged in illegal activities.
Well, everybody does what they have to get by. As long as they're not hurting anybody, I don't bother them.
Is there anything you'd like to know about me?
Hell no. Well, yeah. Why do they make you look so goofy and give you that weird voice?
CyberLife androids are designed to work harmoniously with humans. Both my appearance and voice were specifically designed to facilitate my integration.
Well, they fucked up.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant? Why do you hate androids so much?
I have my reasons.
Maybe I should tell you what we know about deviants.
You read my mind. Proceed.
We believe that a mutation occurs in the software of some androids. which can lead to them emulating a human emotion.
In English, please.
They don't really feel emotions. They just get overwhelmed by irrational instructions, which can lead to unpredictable behavior.
Emotions always screw everything up. The androids aren't as different from us as we thought. You ever dealt with deviants before?
A few months back, a deviant was threatening to jump off the roof with a little girl. I managed to save her.
So I guess you've done all your homework, right? Know everything there is to know about me?
I know you graduated top of your class. You made a name for yourself in several cases and became the youngest lieutenant in Detroit. I also know you've received several disciplinary warnings in recent years, and you spend a lot of time in bars.
So what's your conclusion?
I think working with an officer with personal issues is an added challenge. But adapting to human unpredictability is one of my features. I just got a report of a suspected deviant. It's a few blocks away. We should go have a look. I'll let you finish your meal. I'll be in the car if you need me.
Connor, you run out of batteries or what?
I'm sorry. I was making a report to CyberLife.
Well, do you plan on staying in the elevator?
No. I'm coming.
Now, what do we know about this guy?
Not much. Just that a neighbor reported that he heard strange noises coming from this floor. Nobody's supposed to be living here, but the neighbor said he saw a man hiding an LED under his cap.
Oh, Christ, if we have to investigate every time somebody hears a strange noise, we're gonna need more cops.
Anybody home? Open up, Detroit Police!
Stay behind me.
Got it.
Jesus, this place stinks.
Looks like we came for nothing. Our man's gone. Thank you.
Found something?
I don't know. It looks like a notebook, but it's indecipherable. RT. Probably initials.
You put his initials in his jacket? That's something your mom does when you're in first grade.
The driver's license is fake.
Cool. At least we didn't come for nothing. Any idea what it means?
RA9. Written 2,471 times. It's the same sign Ortiz's android wrote on the shower wall. Why are they obsessed with this sign?
Jesus, I hate these things!
Its LED is in the sink.
Not surprised it was an android. No human could live with all these fucking pigeons.
Fucking pigeons! What are you waiting for? Chase it!
thing wrong. I just want it to be free. You know what they'll do to me if you turn me in.
Model 87400491. Serious malfunctions have been detected in your software, including class 4 errors. You've been deemed defective and will be sent back to CyberLife for deactivation.
Don't you fucking move. You bastard. You saw I was gonna fall and you'd rather let me die than fail your fucking mission.
I had to make a choice. It seemed to me...
What am I to you? A statistic? A zero? A one in your fucking program? Huh? Is that how you see humans, you bastard? Jesus.
I understand you're upset. Perhaps I didn't assess the
Fuck
situation.
You and your fucking assessment. Come here.
Why are you doing this?
All right.
You're one of us.
Shut up.
You're helping humans. You're just their slave.
I said shut up! All right. Come along.
All right, now you save me.
Hey, what the fuck? Holy shit. Fucking androids.
Who are you?
Fugitives. Just like you. My name is Josh.
I'm Simon.
North.
And you knew that only an android could follow the trail, didn't you?
Only those who are like us can find Jericho.
If you could decipher the signs, it's because one of us trusted you enough to give you the key.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho.
And hiding just to stay alive, that's freedom to you?
Humans hate us. Hiding is the only way we can survive.
There is no safe place for those like us. If humans knew we were here, they'd kill us.
How many are you?
There are 19 of us still in working order. The rest were damaged escaping their masters.
Many tried to reach Jericho. Few succeed. Humans have little pity for our kind. I understand how you feel, but we have more freedom here than you ever did.
Waiting in the dark for something to happen? That's not how I see freedom.
You're lost. Just like the rest of us. We didn't ask for this. All we can do now is deal with it.
You're safe here. You can stay with us as long as you want.
Go and see Lucy. She might be able to help you.
Are you Lucy?
Sit down. Show me.
I'll stop the bleeding. Drink this. Give me your hand. You had it all, and you lost it all. You've seen hell, and now hell lives in you. Your heart is troubled. A part of shadow and a part of light. Which will prevail? Your choices will shape our destiny.
Humans are afraid of dying, too. Do you know what happens after death?
No. No, I don't.
Well, I'm about to find out. What's your name?
Marcus.
They threw him out when they didn't want him anymore. He was living on the streets before we brought him here.
They'll all shut down if we don't find a way to help them.
To help them, we need blue blood and biocomponents. We salvage what we can from those who shut down. But there's never enough.
So, how do they survive?
They won't. We're slowly dying out.
what was your function before coming here?
What do you care?
Who found this place?
Nobody knows anymore. Whoever he was, his body's probably laying somewhere on this boat.
A lot of these guys in pretty bad shape.
That's how the humans treat those who disobey. They despise us. They'll never accept what we are. If you came here for comfort, you came to the wrong place.
Shape, am I? My diagnostic program isn't working. I don't think it would have anything good to say anyway.
What happened to you?
They tied me to the back of a car. I think they wanted to have fun. I don't want to shut down. No, I don't want to shut down.
Simon, I know where we can find spare parts. CyberLife warehouses in Detroit Harbor. They have everything we need.
The docks are guarded. We can't just walk in there and take what we want. Humans will never let us.
Which is why we won't ask permission.
We don't have any weapons. And even if we did, none of us knows how to fight.
We can steal what we need without fighting.
We'll just get ourselves killed.
Maybe. But it's better than waiting here to be shut down.
I'm with you.
Maybe it's worth a try.
Okay. I'm in.
Be okay? We'll get some help here. As soon as we'll all be just a bad memory. This is the place.
use Lotco?
Who's asking?
I was told you could help us.
I don't know who told you that. You came to the wrong place. I'm sorry.
Wait. We really need your help.
Come in. Don't be shy. Luther, would you be so kind as to take these ladies' coats? Oh, don't be afraid of our big friend here. Luther is just another android that I helped. Keeps me company in this big, empty old house. Please. Make yourselves at home. How did you hear about me?
An android. On the street, he said you could help us.
I see. Devian, huh? What about her?
She's human.
And you want to find a safe place. Somewhere you can start a new life. I hear Canada is very lovely at this time of year. Beautiful landscapes, open spaces, clean air, and no android laws. Great place for a fresh start.
Yes, that's exactly what we want.
Of course. Well, I can help you. But first, we have to get rid of your tracker.
Tracker?
Yeah. All androids are fitted with a tracking device to locate them at all times. I'll remove yours, and then you'll both be safe. Come on. Follow me. The little one can wait for us in the living room.
No, she always stays with me.
Of course. Right. This way? Everything we need is in the basement.
This place and that man. Let's go. I have a bad feeling.
I know. I don't trust him either. We have to be careful.
Please excuse the mess. I need it somewhere discreet for my machines. Removing trackers is illegal, so I opted for discretion over comfort. I hope the little one isn't too scared. If you could just stand over there. I should warn you, this could be quite unpleasant. You know what's strange? For some unknown reason, the trackers seem to stop working in Deviance. That's why it's so hard to find them. So, actually, there's no reason to remove your tracker.
What? But you said that...
Yeah, people believe what they want. You Deviants are so naive. They'll come to me expecting me to help them. And I just reset them, sell them on. Or I keep them for my little experiments.
No! No! I don't want to be reset! Let me go!
Ah! Oh, I forgot about the child. Lock it up. I'll deal with it later.
Alice! Alice, no!
Wow. Deviant that wants to be a mother. That's so sweet. And so deluded. I think it's time we put you out of your misery. What you get for having a dream. It always ends up the same way. Tears and disillusionment. Believe me, you're better off being erased and feeling nothing. No more pain. No more hopes dashed. I almost envy you.
Kara!
Oh, poor little Alice. Oh, looks like Mommy doesn't remember you at all, huh? Looks like Mommy's completely forgotten you.
Carl, what happened to you?
Oh, all right, that's enough. Come on. You bit me. I'm going to teach you some manners, you little bitch.
Thank you.
Meet me in the living room.
Her memory.
No. This can't be happening.
You have to remember. For her sake.
He likes to play with us. Creating monsters. For his amusement. But who's the real monster? He did to us. You must remember who you are. Otherwise, the little one will die.
Master's dinner's ready. Take it up to him.
Yes, Luther.
Just set it down on the table over there. Now get rid of that carcass. Take it next door.
Bitch took off on a word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking accountant!
Did you hear what I said?
Yes, Lanko.
Luther! Luther!
Yes, Lanko.
I should be done here in 10 minutes or so. I'll have a look at the little one, see what I can do with it.
Understood, Lanko. I'll bring you the little one in 10 minutes.
Okay. We'll get some help here.
Yourselves at home. to find a safe place. Somewhere you can start a new life.
Alice. Forget you. I'm so sorry. You were right. We never should have come here. We have to go. Follow me and don't make any noise, okay?
Here. Go fetch the little one.
Right away, Zako. Zako!
What?
The little one is gone!
Well, I can't have just disappeared. Gotta be here somewhere. What are you waiting for? Go look!
Searching the house. We've got to get out before they find us.
Shit. Where are they?
Luther! Find them, for fuck's sake!
you're there, you sneaky bitch. Show yourself. Get a flashlight. There's one on the table. Come on, show yourself. Look, I'm not gonna hurt you. I only want to talk with you. I know I shouldn't have erased your memory, okay? I regret that now. But just come on out and everything will be all right. I'll help you. Think about that little girl. How's...
There you are!
Get a move on!
I warned you. Dreams always end in tears. You should have listened to me. What are you doing? Get out of my way.
No. Not this time.
I said get out of my way or I'll shoot right through you. How dare you? What are you doing? Who let you out? Get away from me! Get away from me! Obey me! I'm your master! I'm your master!
I saw the little one risk her life to save you. It was like opening my eyes for the first time. Finally, I could see. I know you have no reason to trust me after what I did. But I know someone who could help you across the border. I could take you there. I could protect you. You and the little one.
All right. I trust you. I was so scared of losing you.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, I've been expecting you. Would you mind a little walk? Congratulations, Connor. You managed to find that deviant. Tell me, what did you learn?
The walls of the apartment were covered with drawings of labyrinths and other symbols. Like the other deviants, it seemed obsessed with RA9.
What else?
I found its diary, but it was encrypted. It may take weeks to decipher.
You came very close to capturing that deviant. It's a pity you let it self-destruct.
I knew deviants had a tendency to self-destruct under extreme stress, but I didn't expect it to jump from the roof. I should have anticipated that.
How is your relationship with the lieutenant developing?
He is openly hostile towards me and continues to show no interest in the investigation. Cooperating with him is a real challenge.
We don't have much time. Deviancy continues to spread. It's only a matter of time before the media finds out about it. We need to stop this. Whatever it takes.
I will solve this investigation, Amanda. I won't disappoint you.
A new case just came in. Find Anderson and investigate it.
Lieutenant Anderson! Anybody home? Lieutenant Anderson! Easy, Sumo. I'm your friend. See? I know your name. I'm here to save your owner.